Alright. Here we have a PVT between Hoopsaya and his friend from his friends list, who is also a 5,000 MMR player, okay? This is not for GMs.
Good luck. Have fun.
Disclaimer over. Welcome. This is a PVT scouting guide, alright? So, versus Terran, normally you're not very interested in anything except whether or not they're proxying a building. I like to wait until I build my gateway before I scout. And sometimes I'm even more greedy and I'll wait until I build my gas geyser to scout. But I was being conservative this game for the sake of the guide. We say good luck, have fun to our opponent. You can choose to do whatever you'd like. If you'd like to make your Nexus before your Cybernetics Core, you can do that. But I always make the Cybernetics Core first. So, your probe, it gets to their base, and you don't have to do this, but I poke the worker. What you want to do is find out whether or not they made a gas geyser or not. You want to find out whether or not they made a gas geyser before they made their barracks. I'm a potato, and I'm not going into his base yet, because I lost a lot of HP on my probe. But I do come in here before his Reaper is finished, and I find out that, yes, he did a gas first build. So, that means that the likelihood of him making a Marine after his Reaper is very low. So, we do this with our probe, and then we get out of here before the Reaper shows up. I potato pretty hard this game. I leave in time, but I don't take advantage of a very good hiding spot. So you need to hide this probe really good, because you want this Reaper to pass you and not find your probe, you know? Like, you want this Reaper to pass you by, and then your probe goes back in, and you poke their command center, right? He went gas first, and he made a Marine first. He made a Marine instead of the Reaper. So his build order is not tight. He doesn't have a tight build order. So, stage one of your scouting is over. That's how you scout with the probe. Stage two, Adept, all right? So, since my probe died, and I can't force his Reaper to come home, my Adept has to stay at home. I'm risky. I'm scary and risky. And I let my Adept finish, and I do some shenanigans here. But generally, you're not going to catch the opponent's Reaper. And as long as their Reaper is alive, you need to wait until your second gateway unit finishes before you go across the map with your Adept. I kill his Reaper, so his Reaper's dead. I'm like, okay, now I can go across the map with my Adept and I can find out what he's doing. I goof pretty hard here, and I try to build my first tech building, right? And it just doesn't happen. But this is the timing if you're going to make three gateway units. It's like 2 minutes and 40 seconds, so I goofed hard here. Don't do that, right? So my Adept gets here, and your goal is, I want to see his add-on, and I want to see if I can kill some workers, right? But you don't want to lose the Adept. So I'm like looking around, I'm like, okay, there's his starport, he built it in vision of me. What if they don't build the starport in vision of you? Okay, if they don't build the starport or the factory in vision of you and you can't see this, then what you need to do is hang out down here with your Adept. You need to hang out in an area where he won't be able to surprise you with a couple of Marines and kill your Adept. I get to see his starport, so my reaction to what he's going to do is easy. Make 5 stalkers and wait for his medevac aggression to happen. I don't get to see the tech lab, do I? Okay, so I saw the tech lab too, so I got really lucky, but I didn't even recognize. But we see the Hellion, and we're like, okay, this is great. This is fine, right? Everything's settled. Okay, cool. All right, that's how you scout with your Adept. The rest of this game, not a big deal, okay? I don't scout much else about what the Terran player's doing. I'm not going to do any other scouting for this game. Like, me doing this attack with my stalkers and stuff is because he didn't properly scout me, and he didn't make a low ground bunker when he noticed that I went for a cybernetic score first. So my tech building is very late, and I can't take advantage of my scouting information this game. But I just consistently throw the shade. Just consistently throw the shade into their base over and over and over again until you get to see whether or not it's a Widow Mine or a Hellion or a Cyclone or a Siege Tank. That's what you do with the Adept. You just gotta use the shade to check on them forever. Alright. Stage 1 of Scouting Guide completed, alright? here's stage two. Here's the other way that you can choose to try and scout Terran players. Throwing shade upon your opponent is a strong play. So in this game, instead of opening with a stalker, I open with a sentry. So everything's going to look exactly the same, except we're going to make a sentry instead of a stalker, right? So I build the gateway and I build the gas, and then I go scout with the probe. And the objective is find out if he's going for a gas before Rax or not. If he goes for a Rax first, don't try and hide your probe. If he goes for Rax first, don't try to hide your probe and come back later, because he's just going to have a Marine. But if they go gas before they go Rax, and you can tell by when you come into their base at this time, right? I know that his barracks just finished. He has more than 100 gas mined, and his barracks just finished. He went for a refinery first. Therefore, I'm going to wait around and see, like, did he start his command center? I'm like, okay, he started his command center. Now, I want to go hide. I want this probe to hide. I want to not get killed. So, we chrono boost our adept, and then we chrono boost. We make a sentry. We make a sentry instead of the stalker. Anyways, I can't rely on this versus this player because he's looking for my probe. He got both of my probes in these games. So, our adept knows where his Reaper is at, though. And I see his Reaper here, and I'm like, okay, we can move across the map, because he spent a lot of time not going into my base, right? Like, I don't think he can jump up this cliff. But our sentry wards him off here and keeps the Reaper out of our base. The Adept comes across the map, and we go, hey, he's got Hellions. Okay, so cool, good. We scouted the Hellions. We make our extra gateways, but when we make our extra gateways in the wall off in the natural as a wall off, we also make a shield battery because we scouted the Hellions, okay? So if your adept finds some Hellions, make a shield battery in your natural, okay? Because you're going to need it in case they come here to try and kill your shit. So we hallucinate scout, and what we're looking for here is what buildings are getting put onto what add-ons, right? So I am aware of this. I'm pretty sure that I'm aware of this. I look in here and I'm like, hey, he's researching something from the tech lab. So this is going to change in every game that you play. Your hallucinate scout's going to get to their base and you're just going to see exactly what they're doing, right? And you need to make the smart decisions. You need to be like, they're doing this, so I'm going to do this other thing. He's going for a cloak banshee, so I'm like, oh shit, I didn't build my robo on time. I need to build shield batteries in my mineral lines. I'm like, okay, it's a cloak banshee. I need a shield battery in my mineral lines. So I get a shield battery in this mineral line. And I was going to start a pylon in my natural, but I just didn't. I just decided not to. I'm greedy. I was greedy and I didn't start a pylon in my natural. So end of scouting guide, right? Like, that's all you need to know. What's the opener, the Terran player? And then your goal is fast third base, all your extra gateways and your forges. And that's like your scouting done versus the Terran player. And then when your robo finishes, make 2 to 3 observers and you spread them around. Okay? I'm glad that you enjoyed this. Thank you very much.